वेलकम बैक चिल्ड्रन। सो द लास्ट क्लास वी लर्नड अबाउट हाउ टू बैलेंस द केमिकल इक्वेशन, हाउ टू बैलेंस द केमिकल इक्वेशन। सो आई टोल्ड यू अबाउट द लॉ ऑफ कंजर्वेशन ऑफ मास एंड व्हाई यू हैव टू व्हाई वी हैव टू बैलेंस द इक्वेशन। सो आई टोल्ड यू आई गिवन एन एग्जांपल फॉर अकॉर्डिंग टू द law of conservation of mass, mass cannot be created nor be destroyed in a chemical reaction. In a chemical reaction, number of atoms present in the reactant side should be equal to the product side. So here mass do not changes. 100 gram of calcium carbonate breaks up into calcium oxide and carbon dioxide, and if we say both will be 100 gram, that's why we have to balance the chemical equation. So in the next part of the lesson, we are going to study about type of chemical reactions. So already you know it. So in the old syllabus already you have studied what is this four type of chemical reaction. What are the four type of chemical reactions? So type of chemical reaction. The first one is chemical combination. Chemical combination. Second one is chemical decomposition. Third one is chemical displacement. Double displacement. Type of chemical reaction. So you should be able to identify the equations. Sometimes questions can be given like they give the equation and they will ask to identify the type of chemical reaction. Very simple it is, don't. But this chapter now it makes other chapters very easy, because all other chapters like carbons compound, if you take metals and non-metals, you are going to write the answer by justifying the answer with the equations. Equations barudane justify martira. So equations tumba barutte naaku chapter alli chemistry part alli. So this chapter will give the all the type of chemical reaction, how to balance equation, how to write the equation, all that information will be given. So we'll see, already you know the chemical reactions. We'll see the type of chemical reaction. First one is combination. So it tells about something is combining with something. Like what is that? It's a type of chemical reaction in which two simple element or compound will combine together to form a new product or a large compound. So it is a type of chemical reaction. So it's a type of chemical reaction in which one or two elements or compound will react together to form large compound or a new product. So elements can combine or compound only can combine with this. So examples I can give. So carbon reacts with oxygen to form carbon dioxide. Best example it is. So magnesium reacts with oxygen to form magnesium oxide. Can give. So balance this equation, it is an unbalanced equation. Where 2 over here, because Mg is 1 over here, oxygen is 2 over here, oxygen is 2 over here. Here it is 1, that's why I will multiply by 2 over here. When you multiply this whole compound by 2, magnesium also becomes 2, that's why here also we had 2. So it is balanced now. So here see, two simple elements form a compound. A compound will be formed. Like that you can give the example of carbon dioxide. It's a compound reacting with the water. Water with the reactor. Water with react again, H2CO3 formation. It's a carbonic acid. This is used in soft drinks. All your soft drinks like Coca-Cola, Fanta, whatever you drink. So 7-Up maybe. All that, it is made up of the carbonic acid. This is carbonic acid, H2CO3. One more example you can give, calcium oxide reacting with water. So here, this is the calcium oxide is a compound, and it's also compound. It forms what? So it forms CaOH plus calcium hydroxide will be formed. Here see, two smaller compounds will react to form a large compound. You can write this example. So this is how the chemical combination happens. Very simple reaction with this. So chemical combination is a process, it's a type of chemical reaction in which one or two elements or compound will react together to form a new product or a new large compound. A large compound will be formed. This is known as chemical combination. Understood? I hope you have written this. Say N2 plus H2. So reacts to form NH3. Balance this equation. So I'll tell the names to those who have to answer this. Parag, balance this equation. Everyone, balance this equation. Balance this equation and send it in the chat box. Same children are sending in chat box. Others are, I don't know what happening. Are you understanding or not understanding? You don't ask the question also here. Aditya Agde, yeah. Purnachandra, same children are giving the answer. I don't know what happened to others. Aryan, Pranati Naik, okay. So nitrogen, how many are there? So everyone understood this, some may be there, those who not understood how to write how to balance the equation, for them it is. So others don't think that it's repeating. So nitrogen, how many? Nitrogen, two are there. But in case of here, nitrogen is 1, nitrogen is 3 over here. See, hydrogen is 3 over here it is 2. So we cannot make 3, no? So you cannot write like 1 and you cannot make it like. Or you can write 3 over here. Write 3. 3 to the 6 it becomes. 3 to the 6, how many hydrogen become 6 now, but here it is 3, here it is 3. So make it here, we have to make 6. For making 6, we have to multiply by 2 over here. When you multiply by 2 over here, the whole compound changes. Nitrogen becomes 2 and hydrogen becomes 6. So it is, now it is balanced. Now it is balanced. See, this is how to balance the equation. See, this is a type of chemical, the first type of chemical reaction, that is chemical combination. Combination, and the name of this suggests, it's a combination type of combination. Here one element will combine with another element to form a large compound, or a simple element combined with another simple element to form a large compound. Large compound. Understood? So this is how it happens actually. So there is another type of reaction in this, exothermic reaction. Exothermic reaction means what? Exo means outside, thermic means heat. The reaction in which heat is liberated, or during the reaction, if heat is liberated, the reaction in which heat is liberated is called exothermic reaction. So HCl combines with NaOH to form NaCl plus H2O. This is the exothermic reaction because here heat is liberated. Triangle symbol, heat is liberated. Triangle symbol tells about heat is liberated. So like this, heat is liberated. This type of reactions are called as exothermic reaction, in which heat is liberated. Is it clear? If it is, heat is produced during the reaction, heat can be produced or it can be observed. So those type of reaction are called as exothermic reaction. Remember this. This is a acid-base reaction. This is a acid plus base reacts to form NaCl salt plus water. So this is called as an exothermic reaction. ಯಾವುದರಲ್ಲಿ ಹೀಟ್ ಲಿಬರೇಟ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ ಆ ರೆಸ್ಪಿರೇಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಎ ಎಕ್ಸೋಥರ್ಮಿಕ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್. ಸೊ ವೈ ಟ್ರಯಾಂಗಲ್ ಸಿಂಬಲ್? ಸೊ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಸಿಂಬಲ್. ಸಿಂಬಲ್ ಇಸ್ ಗಿವನ್, ದಟ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್. ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ಎನಿ ರೀಸನ್ ದಟ್ ವೈ ಟ್ರಯಾಂಗಲ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್, ಬಟ್ ಸಿಂಬಲ್ ಇಸ್ ಗಿವನ್. Okay, so this is about the chemical combination. So next type of reaction, that is chemical next type of reaction is chemical decomposition reaction. Chemical decomposition reaction. So chemical decomposition reaction means what? So decomposition, the word meaning of decomposition is what? Something is breaking. So like something is breaking. So somebody was saying So respiration is also a exothermic reaction. Yeah, respiration is exothermic reaction. So it liberates heat. During the respiration, heat will be produced. That's why our when we breathe out, when we breathe out, our the expelled out air will be hot. That is because of the respiration which takes place, and respiration is called as exothermic reaction. Exothermic reaction. So second one, that is chemical. Sorry, decomposition. 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 So, it's a type of reaction. It's a type of reaction in which a large compound, breaks into two or more smaller compounds or elements. So a large compound can break up into two smaller compounds. A large compound, here see, in the first reaction, chemical combination, what happens? Two simple elements combine to form a large compound. In this, it is a slightly different, like it's opposite in case of chemical combination. It is opposite to chemical combination. There, two simple product, simple compounds or elements combine to form a large compound. But in this reaction here, a large compound breaks up into two smaller compounds. Understood? The best example can give you, already we have seen this example, calcium carbonate breaking into calcium oxide plus carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide, the best example you can give over here. So triangular shape. So heat is given over here. It's a decomposition reaction. Decomposition reaction. Heat is given here, means it's a endothermic reaction. So what is endothermic reaction? Reaction in which heat is absorbed by compound to break into smaller compounds, smaller elements or compound. Like this, any compound can take and you can break it. Means we have to provide the heat. We have to provide the heat. When you provide heat, they break into two smaller compound. Smaller compound, if you tell. Understood? So can you give one more example? Like it is given in your textbook. It is Fe2O3. Fe2O3 is one, I think. So like see here, what happens? Breaks here. A large compound will break into two smaller compound. So there is a, so in your textbook they have given examples of PbNO3, that is potassium nitrate. Potassium nitrate, PbNO3, yes. This will break into PbO plus NO2 plus O2. This example is given. This is also a decomposition reaction in which it breaks. So here lead nitrate breaks up into PbO. Oxide will be formed. So oxide will be formed, and here, so two type of oxide is called, oxygen is also liberated. So this is also a chemical decomposition reaction. Example for chemical decomposition, decomposition. So all these decomposition reaction are usually they are what? They are endothermic reaction. All type of decomposition reaction are actually endothermic reaction. They means they need heat to break. That's right. They need heat to break. So breaks up. So remember like this. So here see, this is nitrogen dioxide, which is a brown color gas. Brown color colored gas will be liberated. Remember this again. It comes in the chapter metals and non-metals. Metals and non-metals. Again, it is going to repeat. So please see that. So this is. So here in this type of reaction, there are three subtype of reaction. So chemical. See, thermal decomposition. Thermal decomposition. Thermal decomposition. Then B. Second one is photochemical reaction. Photochemical reactions are there. Then one more is that photochemical reaction. Then next one is electrochemical reaction. Electrochemical reaction. So these are the three type of decomposition reaction. See, first one is thermal decomposition, means we are providing heat. So this is the best example. Calcium carbonate breaks into CaO, that is calcium oxide, and carbon dioxide will be released. It's the best example for thermal decomposition. We are providing heat to break the compound. So second one is photochemical reaction. Photo refers to light. So by the help of light, the compound will break into two smaller elements or two smaller compounds. So chemical photochemical reaction, the reaction in which light will be used to break the compound. Next, electrochemical reaction. Electro, it refers to the electricity. We are providing electricity to break the compound. We are providing electricity, electrolysis. Electrolysis means what? So it is a process of breaking the compound, a large compound, into two smaller compound or two smaller elements by using electricity in the aqueous state. So this all these three type of decomposition reaction, I'll explain it in next class. So I hope you understood the whatever thought today. So I have taught you balancing of chemical equation, how to write the chemical equation, how to balance the equation, and type of chemical reaction that we have studied in this session. So in the next class, we are going to study about type of decomposition reaction and other type of reactions. Okay. Any doubt you have? If you have any doubt, please ask now. Otherwise, we will end the science class today. So what is catalyst? Pranav is asking, what is catalyst? See, catalyst are the substances which are used to change the rate of reaction. Rate of reaction means to increase. Sometimes we need, all this chemical reaction, where it is used? In chemical industry they use. Sometimes the chemical making the product should be very fast, or the production should be increased. During that time, some catalyst will be used in the reactions to increase the rate of reaction or decrease the rate of reaction. Both are there. Catalysts are the substances which are used to increase the rate of reaction or decrease the rate of reaction. So you'll come across many of the catalysts used in different process in the chapters, different chapters. I'll tell you in case of this electrochemical equation, we use some catalyst or some reactions we'll see. So in the next chapter, you have metals and non-metals, or you'll have a carbons compound there. The use of a catalyst will be given in the some processes. Process means some productions. So there we are going to study about the. There we are going to study about the types of catalyst also. Pranav, have you understood?
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Okay. So we'll see in the next class. Thank you very much. Have a nice day. Social class will be there next. Attend the class. Thank you.